Good morning. All my blessed people, report to Morning Manna. Come on, Facebook. Tag your friends. YouTube. Like the video and share. Good morning. Happy Monday. Good morning. Good morning. Tag and share. Get your tribe keepers in the room. Good morning. Get your tribe keepers up. Good morning. Tag and share. Get your tribe keepers up. Happy Monday. Good morning. Happy Monday, tribe keepers. Tag and share. Get your tribe keepers up. Happy Monday. You want to see a blessing? Just look at me. Happy Monday. Invite new people to the tribe. Good morning. Tag, get your tribe keepers in here. Tell them, get yourself up on this Monday morning. YouTube, welcome. Like the video and share. The lower you get, the more God gonna bless you. My. Happy Monday. Thank you, Jesus. Whew. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning, tribe. Hallelujah. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Hearts on the screen for hallelujah. Hearts on the screen to say, God, thank you, Jesus. Good morning, tribe. Hallelujah. Good morning. Hearts on the screen to say, God, thank you, Jesus. Welcome, Facebook. Welcome, YouTube. God bless you. Yes, oh God. Thank you, Jesus. Hearts on the screen to let God know I appreciate everything you've done, God. Thank you, Jesus. Give God the glory. Happy Monday. Good morning. Hearts on the screen. Show God some love. Good morning. Blessings on blessings. Yes. Good morning, tribe. Happy Monday. Listen, give God the glory. He's watched over us all weekend. He's been a keeper. He's been a sustainer. He's been a provider. Listen, has the Lord been good to anybody? Hearts on the screen, praise, hands up. Let God know, God, I appreciate you. God, thank you so much for being a keeper. Thank you for watching over me. Thank you for providing. Thank you for being a place, Father, that I can run to. Thank you for being a constant Father, a constant friend. Thank you for listening to me, Jesus. Thank you that when I call on you, you hear me. Thank you, Father, that you can interpret every tear that streams down my face. Thank you, God, that when I open my mouth, you can interpret what I'm saying. You can interpret my moans and groans. God, thank you for the lights being on. Come on, somebody. Thank you for celebrating another day of life, of breath, being in my right mind. Listen, when you come very close to the edge of losing it, you thank God for being in your right mind. Come on, somebody. Listen, I don't know how many times, come on, God has kept you in your right mind. Give him the glory. It is so true. He won't put any more on us than we can bear. We feel like we're going to break. We feel like we're going to snap. We feel like we're going to lose it. And he lets us know, no. I got you. I got you. Just in that moment, he sends angelic help. He sends encouragement. He sends release. He sends peace. He sends a rest. Come on, give him the glory. Give him the glory. God, I thank you. I thank you. I thank you. You better give him the glory. 600,000 plus and counting people are not able to sit here and do what we do. They didn't know it was, oh Jesus, they didn't have a clue. Give God the glory. Healing virtue is in the room. Provision, more than enough, is in the room. El Shaddai is in the room. El Shalom is in the room. Give him the glory. Come on, come on. Come on. Good morning, tribe. Happy Monday. Listen, for those of you here on Facebook, tag and share. Get your tribe keepers up. Say, listen, I don't know what you did all weekend, friend, but come on in the room. Get on up. Now, listen, YouTube, thank you for being here. Like the video, share. Thank you so much for sharing the videos with your family and friends. I'm trying to go back today and read the comments and respond. Y'all bear with me. I'm learning how to do a little bit more multitasking. The Lord is putting more and more on my plate, but I do believe what he spoke to me around October, November last year, Teresa. He said, to whom much is given. Come on, somebody. Much is required. Come on, come on. I don't know why he chose. I'm scratching my head, but I give him the glory because he chose me. But not only did he choose me, he gonna have to keep me. Not only is he gonna have to keep me, he gonna have to lead and guide me. Not only is he gonna have to lead and guide me, he gonna have to provide what I need for where he's taking me and for where he's sending me. Come on, somebody. Give him the glory. Say welcome to our new tribe keepers. They just keep coming in each and every day. All of you are sowing the seed of an invite, and I want to say thank you for sowing the seed of an invite. Thank you for inviting new tribe keepers every day. Thank you for those of you that are inviting people to the YouTube page. If you haven't subscribed, ask your friend, what's wrong with you? What you waiting on? Subscribe to the YouTube page, Michelle Repurpose Evans. Go over there and subscribe to YouTube. So maybe while you're at work, if you can't be on the little blue app, the Facebook app, you're able to be on YouTube listening to the word. Come on, give God the glory. for what he is doing. Welcome our new tribe keepers, and thank you each and every one of you who go out every single day and invite your friends, invite your family to the tribe. God bless you for sowing the seed. Whatsoever you sow, oh Jesus, you encouraging folks, you shall reap, you shall be encouraged. Whatsoever you do for the least of them, God said, you've done this to me. You bless them, now I'm getting ready to bless you. Come on, give them the glory. Thank you so much. Thank you for those of you that go to the website and buy the t-shirts, that you go out there and you submit prayer requests, you drop me little notes. God bless you. The website is repurposedtribe.com, repurposedtribe.com. I want you to know that my prayer team and I come together weekly. We're praying together, praying for one another, but we are praying for you. They're looking at the comments. They're paying attention. They see the prayer requests. Drop your prayer requests on the page so people can pray for you. Drop them in my inbox. We want to agree with you. Listen, if one can chase, how many can all of us coming together do? Good morning to each and every one of you. Good morning, Krishan, Mother May Long, Mother Ruby Haskins, who celebrated 70 beautiful plus 70 years this weekend. Give God the glory for 70 years. God has graced her, and the new season has already begun. Give God glory for her newness. Come on, somebody, praise him for her newness so you can get yours. Good morning, Sandra Slaughter. Good morning to each and every one of you, Krishan, Kimberly. Good morning, V. Good morning, Sharissa. Good morning to each and every one of you. Natista, good morning. I give God the glory. Good morning, Mother Eva, Tamika, Audrey, all the way in New York, Gail Watkins. God bless each and every one of you. God bless you this morning. God bless you. Good morning, Christine. Good morning, Trina 3. Thank you, Jesus. Mother Ruby Haskins, you ain't seen nothing yet. No eye has seen, no ear has heard, neither has it even entered the heart of man, what God, the good things he's getting ready to do in this next season. Give God. Good morning, Stacy Morgan. Good morning to you, Bonnie. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Come on. Come on. Let's go on to the word here, because I have to be on another prayer call at 7 a.m. and my day is full. I need y'all praying for your girl. Listen, the Lord keeps stretching. Listen, didn't we talk last week? Good morning, Tammy Fincher. I thank God that you are with Vanessa Starks, good morning to you. Didn't we talk last week? Haven't we been talking about God stretching us and us making room, having the capacity for what we say we want? Oh, Jesus. Every now and then, you got to look yourself in the mirror and say, okay, Rachel, good morning to you. We have to look ourselves in the mirror, Mother Gail Watkins, and ask God, am I really ready to receive, come on here, Krishan, for what I'm asking for? Am I really ready to receive? Oh, my God, Krishan, my Lord, you are on the heartbeat and the pulse of what God is speaking in this season. The Spirit is definitely speaking to you. My God, didn't God has asked us, Letitia, are you ready? Do you have the capacity for what you say you want? Ask yourself, are you really ready to receive for what you're believing God for? Could it be that the answer hasn't come yet, because God says, I'm looking to see if you have room for what you're asking for, and I don't yet see room? Oh, you're asking, oh, I'm going to bring it down to where we can all understand it. You asking God for a new car, and in the garage, that old broke down car just been sitting there, taking up space, taking up room. I need you to call somebody today. Call somebody and say, listen, I need you to come through here. Come through 1-800-JUNK, somebody. Somebody come to my house, come to where I am, and pick up all the stuff that's taking up room, that's in the way of the new things that I'm asking God for. Come through and pull this piece of junk car out of the way to make room. What am I saying in the spirit? What is in your spirit? I hear you, oh God. What's in your soul? What's in your spirit? What's in your place that's taking up room, that's in the way of you receiving, oh my God, what you say you want? Quit running around with old girl and old boy when you say you want a husband and a wife, when you know they ain't it. You don't want to be alone. It's okay. You keep prolonging what you're asking for by making room for the wrong thing. I don't know where that came from, but God, I thank you today. You better hear the Spirit of the Lord speaking. That ain't in no kind of notes. That, listen, that just dropped on me. Make room. Go grow. Capacity. You can handle it, but do you have the room to hold it? Oh my God. You can handle it if you had it, but do you have room? Oh, grossa. You're asking for more, and God is looking at how you manage the little. You're asking for more, and He's looking at how you steward the minimum. Oh my God. Let's pull your tithing records. Let's pull how you treat folk. Let's pull how you get. Let's pull how you deal with people. Let's pull how you keep your house clean when you want a bigger house. Let's pull what you, come on here, somebody. God is looking at how we manage and steward everything. You saying, I need more time. And if He was to pull your time card, oh God, how much time you clocking with Him? Oh Jesus, Lord, it's too early on a Monday morning. You want more time. He said, well, I'm waiting to see what you're going to do with the 24 hours I give you. Ah, God, help us. Show us how to make ready and make room. Make ready and make room. That's the word in the spirit today. Make ready and make room. Stop calling my phone because you taking up space. See, thank you, Holy Ghost. We getting ready to move on now, Lord Jesus. Listen, last weekend, Krishan, I have six email addresses. Mm-hmm. Six email addresses. And so, Quinette Frazier, make room, make ready here. You better hear what God is saying. Make room and make ready. Last weekend, Tammy, Trina 3. Last weekend, Tammy Fincher. Last weekend, Pauline. I was sitting there on the sofa, just in my Sabbath, just in my pajamas, just being a bum. You know, I believe I'd ate some ice cream. You know, none of your business. You know what I'm saying? And I'm sitting there, and emails are coming through, and I'm sifting through emails. And I got frustrated, Pauline. I got, that's it, Tammy. Make room, make ready. And my mother, Eva, I got frustrated because I'm looking through all of these emails. Because, you know, when you buy a product, when you sign up for a service, they want all your credentials. They want to know who your mom and daddy is, what your blood type is. You got to put your email in for everything. And before you know it, Rachel Anderson, you're being bombarded. I'm like, I didn't sign up for this. How are all these emails, Adrian, coming into me? I don't want this. I don't have time to read this. I barely have time to read the essential ones. Oh, come on, somebody. And so I said, okay, I'm getting ready to do this right now. And I do this about once every 6 months anyway. But out of frustration, Gail Watkins, I went through, and I just started erasing. Oh, come on here. I started deleting. Help me, Holy Ghost. I hear you, God. I started deleting emails. I started unsubscribing to stuff that I was like, I know I put my email in for that product, but I don't want you emailing me 50 them times a day. I don't want you emailing me every other minute. I don't want all these emails. I don't have time to read them. You're not going to be bullying me to buy your product. You're not going to be taking up space in my head and in my phone. And so I just started unsubscribing. Listen, let me tell you something. Some places make it real hard to unsubscribe. Tammy, I promise you, you do it, you will feel a whole lot better. I'm hitting, I'm I'm going down. And you know, at the bottom of the email, come on here, somebody, it's easy to get in, but it's harder to get out. Oh, Jesus. I go down to the bottom of the email, and unsubscribe is so tiny. You got to zoom it in and pinch and pull it in and unsubscribe, and you got to find it. They got it hidden in all this jargon at the bottom of the page because they don't want you to do it. You hit unsubscribe, Tracy. You hit unsubscribe, LC Farley. You hit unsubscribe. It take you to another page, and they have the nerve to ask you why you want to unsubscribe. Can you tell us what the problem is? Can we modify how many emails a week we send you? Can we send you less emails? Listen, we won't bother you every minute. We'll just do it every hour. No. I want out altogether. I want out altogether. And you hit unsubscribe from all. Come on here, Krishan Patrick. It have the nerve, Pauline, to take you to another page and ask you, Christine Smiley, to enter your email address again, Mother Ruby. I mean, it frustrates you into the point where you don't want to unsubscribe, Laureen Daniel. But I said, the devil is a lie. I copied and pasted my email 100 times, Tammy Clark. But I tell you what, this past week, there were less emails and less interruptions. I unsubscribed from stuff I did not need. I don't read them. Bought your product one time, won't buy it again, so I don't want you emailing. I don't need it. Listen, when I get ready to buy something, I'll go to the coupon code, and if I need it, I can listen. Some of y'all need to unsubscribe. Oh, Jesus. And make room. Come on, let's go to the word. Whew. Thank you, Jesus. I feel it lifting now. 2 Timothy 2:4. Somebody put this on the screen. Make room, make ready. I don't know what y'all need to do. I don't know which one of y'all is putting up with stuff and you keep entertaining stuff and you keep making room for stuff that you do not want. I don't know how many of you keep doubling back and going back to stuff you say you don't want to deal with no more. I don't know how many of you need to delete and block on all platforms. Don't just block the text messages. Block them in Messenger, block them in your DMs, your M&Ms, you can't get to me no kind of way. Oh, Jesus, I have to do that every other day or so. Tammy Clark, how you get in here anyhow? How you get in my inbox? Bro, what you want? Stop bothering me. Go to your page. You got a whole wife and some children. Why are you trying to roll up on me? Talking about, hey, beautiful. You don't even know how to talk to me. Agitate the gravel. Stop bothering me. Make room, make ready. That means y'all got to stop entertaining stuff that ain't got nothing to do with you. 2 Timothy 2:4. Y'all have no clue. I'm blocking foolishness all day. I got my life. Wonder Woman with my bracelets on. I'm blocking mess all day long. Bye, be gone. Poof, pow, be gone. I don't have time for it. Leave me alone. Leave me be. Stop. You need to stop while you ahead, because if I expose you, listen, I don't do mess. I don't do petty, but please don't push me. Oh, don't push me. 2 Timothy 2:4. I ain't studying y'all today. 2 Timothy 2:4. Listen to what this says. I want some of y'all to hear this because you've got to get focused. Tomorrow is our last day of the 90-day completion. However, it's not the end of the year. We got to finish strong. Some of y'all have got to focus. Some of y'all have got to quit entertaining all kinds of stuff. Make room, make ready. Y'all going to be hearing that all day long. Y'all can tag me in that too, but I'm getting ready to tell you what to do. 2 Timothy 2:4. 2 Timothy 2:4. I'm going to read it in a couple of translations. God, I thank you today. 2 Timothy 2:4. I'm going to read it in the New King James Version first, and then I'm going to go over to some other versions. No one engaged in warfare entangles. I want you to hear the words. No one engaged. Listen to the words. When you read the scripture, I want you to pause and chew on every word. No one engaged. This ain't no passive stuff. I'm engaged in my life. I'm engaged in what I'm called to do. No one, otherwise I wouldn't be up at 4:00 every morning. Trust me. trust. No one engaged in God. This is a God thing. Trust me, nothing in my flesh want to sit here and do this. It's all spirit. No one engaged in warfare, listen, entangles himself. Oh, this is a choice. Okay. No one engaged in warfare entangles himself with the affairs of this world. Oh, a foolishness. Okay. That he may please him who enlisted him as a soldier. Okay, let me read it in the Passion Translation. For every soldier called, oh, come on here, to what? To active duty. Must, here's the prerequisite, must divorce himself from distractions of this world. Why? So that he may fully satisfy the one who chose him. You walking around here talking about God called you to do something. Why you keep entangling yourself in foolishness? I want you to go out to your main page today, tag your girl in, and this is what we're going to say. Stop your mess. Oh, stop your mess. Last week alone, I had to talk to a few people that are going through some things with family and friends and enemies, work, boss, employers, employees. And they don't even realize. They keep getting reeled into mess. I look at their page. I look at their stories. They being low-key petty. I ain't going to bother it no more. I ain't going to say nothing else about it. I look at your stories. There you are with your bobblehead bounce self being petty. There you are putting up stories, trying to see who gonna click on it to see who read it so that you can see who saw what you said so you can get your point across. Quit being a coward and using social media to speak to people. If you need to confront somebody, if you need to sit down and have a whole adult conversation with somebody, be man and woman enough to call them up and say, listen, I don't know what happened, but listen, this ain't, you know, I didn't mean it. You know, can we get some clarity? Listen, I'm cutting family off. I'm cutting folk off. If you do it, do it. Stop announcing it to the world. Stop putting it on social media. Stop including social media in your family mess that's been going on since Big Mama went to heaven and died, and she up in glory with her robe walking on the streets of gold, and you still mess, carrying on mess, just messy for no reason. Tell them, stop your mess. You know what? I am fully convinced, Stacey Morgan. I'm fully convinced, Tammy Clark. I'm fully convinced that people who are not walking in their purpose, who don't know what they're supposed to be doing with their life, get entangled in mess, get entangled in tit for tat foolishness because they don't have nothing else going for themselves. They life ain't serving no purpose. They ain't doing nothing for, they ain't doing nothing with their life. They ain't trying to birth no business. They ain't walking in no calling. They ain't doing nothing. They going to work, clocking in, clocking out. They ain't doing nothing else with their lives. They ain't doing nothing. So that's how you got time to be petty. That's how you got time to be sending 3 and 4 paragraphs messages with your, that's crazy to me. No soldier. Where the real soldiers at? Will the real soldiers please stand up? Oh my God. Where my soldiers at? Oh, come on here. Who about it? Where my soldiers at? Where, come on, y'all, please. I'm sick of the body of Christ. I'm sick of folks that saying, I love God. You don't love God? What's wrong with you? I can't tell. Stop your mess. You going back and forth with folks. Your stories are messy. Your posts are subliminal jabs and shade. Get yourself a life. Get yourself a purpose here. Get yourself something to do other than, you know, what soldier? No soldier. For every soldier called into active duty. Let me say something to you. Anybody on the front line ain't got no time to be worrying about what's going on back at the barracks. Anybody on the front line click that's locked and loaded. No, they ain't got time to be caught, be looking around at distractions. They gotta be on high alert. Do 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 at all times. I'm locked and loaded. I wish you would cross the line about my kids. I wish you would cross the line, devil, about my grandbabies. I wish a devil would mess with my mama and my family. I wish you would think you can roll up on me and roll out the same way. Click, click, I'm locked and loaded. Who rolling? Any soldier. I'm sick of the body of Christ wasting. And we talking about the same thing month after month after month. Please bother somebody else. Lose my number here. No soldier. See, I'm talking to people that say, listen, I ain't got time to waste. 600,000 float folks was zipped up in body bags last year that thought they had time. See, when you really think about that, like for real, and sit down in it and sit with it, 600,000 folks didn't make it. My friend from New Orleans called me the other day. He said, listen, he said, I'm just going to live life to the fullest. I'm boarding up my windows. I'm coming through Birmingham. Meet me out at Bucky's. I said, Bucky's? You kidding me? Bucky's? I live here and ain't never been to Bucky's. He said, oh my God, you got to do Bucky's. It's Walmart. I said, bro, I don't even do Walmart. Bro, you serious? And we got to talking about some things. And we have heated conversation. We've been friends for 20-some years. And we met in South Carolina. And he was like, well, I said, you don't. And so we got into something and a little heated conversation like we always do. Then we laugh it off. He said, girl, come through. Let me buy you something to eat. Listen, we're going to meet at the Nike outlet, bruh. And we got into a heated conversation, Christine Smiley, because I told him there are some things you can't attest to and identify with because you've never had any real responsibilities. Yeah, you can pack up and you be texting me from and calling me FaceTime. And me from New Mexico, because you can do that. You ain't got no responsibilities. You ain't got no ties. You keep us a bag on ready. You ain't got no set schedule. And he said something to me. He said, listen, baby girl, he said, I love you with every fiber of my being. He said, I ain't never married another woman because I want you to be my wife. I said, you need to stop all your mess. He said, listen, I don't apologize for living life to the fullest. He said, my homeboys done been run over and killed and died for no reason. He said, people that my mama and daddy dead, some of my siblings are dead. He said, listen, I'm going to live my life to the fullest. He said, I know I'm not going to make no apologies for it. I'm going to focus on what I'm supposed to be doing with my life. Then he went over his 5-year plan with me right quick. He said, I didn't forget what we talked about last time. I did my homework. Here it is. He said, I got a life plan. He said, I can't be out here at 50 and 55 applying for jobs and filling out applications. He said, people getting ready to fend the work for me. He said, I'm doing what you told me to do. And I want to say that to you this morning. You better focus on what God has called you to do. Stop your mess. Stop your mess. Life is but a vapor. Life is short. You sitting here, I really want to walk in my calling too. Then stop your mess. I really want to do what God has called me to do. Then stop entertaining any and everything. Go out to your main pages here on YouTube. Drop it in the comments. Hashtag stop your mess. What soldier? No. In the Amplified Version and in the New King James Version, the word of the Lord says no soldier. No soldier engaged, called to active duty, entangles. I ain't got time to get entangled. We had a Bible study back in January, and one of the week's topics was entanglements. What? It was the Bible study series, Minding Your Business, all the way in January. Can y'all believe it? It's getting ready to be September, and the Lord took me through all that we've done this year. Back in January, we did a Bible study, hashtag Minding Your Business, and one of the topics was entanglements. Oh, Jesus. No soldier entangles himself. One version says in civilian affairs, but rather tries to please his commanding officer. Who is our commanding officer? Jesus. Jesus called me. That's who I answer to at the end of every day. Jesus. I don't care what people think about me. I don't care what you say. Just you might as well keep it to yourself. You better take it to the Lord in prayer. All I know, stop your mess. I want to talk to somebody this morning. I don't know what you're supposed to be doing. I don't know what you're supposed to be focusing on. I don't know what you keep giving all your energy to. I don't know what you keep going back and forth with people about. Stop. Stop it. You don't have time to keep doing that. You don't have time. You don't have time. God, I thank you for your word. Thank you for your tribe. Speak now. You can sow into this word. They're going to put the information on the screen. I'm going to speak a blessing over you. I got to get prepared, mic'd up, and ready for another call. Listen, the Lord is going to cause your lines to fall in smooth places on today. I bless you, and I say his grace and mercy are going to overtake you today and blow your mind. Focus, soldier. Listen, we'll be back here tomorrow morning for what? The heat, the fire, the word, the manna. I love you, tribe. Simple as that. Have a wonderful day. God bless you.